Douglas Hofstadter is a cognitive scientist, physicist, and author. I'm sure he has told many good and true stories in his life, but my favorite Hofstadter tale describes something that happened years ago in his physics class at Hunter College in downtown New York City. Hofstadter wanted to teach his college students about estimates and significant figures, so he asked them to estimate the height of the Empire State Building, which his students had seen many times and could see at that moment from their 13th floor classroom window in Manhattan. Hofstadter says that in a class of 10 students, no one came within a factor of 2 of the correct answer. Yikes! The true height of the Empire State Building is 1,250 feet. Not counting the television antenna. Hofstadter tells us that, quote, one person thought 50 feet was right, a truly amazing underestimate. Another thought it was a mile, unquote. Hofstadter concluded with this, quote, it is fashionable for people to decry the appalling illiteracy of this generation, particularly its supposed inability to write grammatical English. But what of the appalling innumeracy of most people, old and young, when it comes to making sense of the numbers that, in point of fact, and whether they like it or not, run their lives? Unquote. Let's see if we can put a dent in this innumeracy problem. Let's see if we can get a grip on something very basic, what I'll call the triple powers of 10. 1,000. A 1 followed by 3 zeros, 10 times 10 times 10, 10 to the third power, I'll call T3. 1 million, a 1 followed by 6 zeros, 10 times itself 6 times, 10 to the sixth power, or T6. 1 billion is 10 times itself 9 times, 10 to the ninth power, T9. And 1 trillion is 10 times itself 12 times, 10 to the 12th power, T12. I've just invented that T notation. I do wish it would catch on. The common way of writing powers of 10 involves notation that is difficult for computers and for typesetters. Let's just agree that a capital T followed by an integer represents the corresponding power of 10. So T15 is 10 to the 15th power, a quadrillion. And T-6, read T-6, is 10 to the negative sixth power, that is 1 millionth, 1 divided by 1,000,000. To get used to these extreme numbers, and to make them a little exciting, imagine that they are numbers of dollars. 1,000 T3 dollars is a lot of money, but most of us will handle that amount of money given enough time. $1,000,000, on the other hand, many of us will never see. $1,000,000 might also be called a megabuck, because the prefix mega means million. Since kilo means thousand, a kilobuck is $1,000. How about $1,000,000,000? That may be unimaginable for many of us. There are very few billionaires in the world. Almost no one has a gigabuck in the bank. Finally, $1 trillion is dealt with only in huge economies. National debts sometimes number in the trillions of dollars. No individual is a trillionaire. No one person has a terabuck in the bank. Let's see if you've got a grip on the triple powers of 10. I'm going to ask a few multiple choice questions, requiring you to estimate a numerical answer to the nearest triple power of 10. It's multiple choice, so you can't look too bad. You know the answer has to be one of these. Question number one. How many students attend an average high school in the USA? I suppose you could look this up fairly easily, but that's not the point. Hofstadter students could have looked up the height of the Empire State Building, too. The point is that everyone should be able to make decent estimates, at least to the nearest triple power of 10. Have you made your estimate of the average high school population? Remember, it's multiple choice. You must choose from T3, T6, T9, and T12. Even if you happen to know the precise average population of an American high school, you still need to round off to the nearest triple power of 10. All right, what's your answer? I hope you said T3, 1,000. There are plenty of schools, many of them private, that have fewer than 100 students. But there are also some schools, relatively few, with populations of 5,000. T3 is a reasonable estimate. It's certainly the closest of our four choices. Question number 2. What is the population of San Francisco? I hope you said 1,000,000, T6. T3 is clearly too small because a city like San Francisco has many high schools. And if you go up to T9, you're talking about the population of the very biggest countries. Question number 3. What is the population of the North American continent? 1,000,000,000, T9, is a reasonable estimate. Everyone ought to know the approximate population of the planet, around 7 billion. So to think that one of the 7 continents has 1,000,000,000 people is reasonable. Certainly more reasonable than the multiple choice alternatives. Speaking of which, question number 4. How many people have ever lived? You might think that I'm looking for an answer of 1 trillion, T12, the next and only unused possible answer in the triple power of 10 sequence. But this question is much harder than the others. For one thing, it's imprecise. When considering number of people over very long timescales, we have to be clear about what constitutes people. The archaeology of only 1,000,000 years ago, that's T6 years, reveals no evidence of Homo sapiens. We found evidence of other members of the genus Homo, folks like this. But if you saw one of these 1,000,000 years ago guys, a T6 guy walking toward you on the sidewalk, you'd probably cross to the other side of the street. If we go back 100,000, that is T5 years, we do encounter anatomically modern humans. I'm pretty much a T5 guy. Consider that 20 years is roughly the duration of a single human generation. So 100,000 years is about 5,000 generations. That's a nice insight. All of human existence spans 5 or 10,000 generations. Your great-grandparents, 10,000 times removed, would barely be human. 10,000 generations is a lot of people. But could it add up to 1,000,000,000,000 people, T12? That's 1,000,000,000,000. No, it can't. 10,000 generations won't even get us to 100,000,000,000 people, T11, far less T12. Here's why. Look at the human population growth curve. Only 10 generations ago, that's about 1800, Earth's population was near 1,000,000,000, T9. 100 generations ago, that's 2,000 years ago, the population was near 1/10 of a billion, T8. But 1,000 generations ago, it was near 1,000,000,000, T6, and was fairly stable going back 100 times further. Even though today's population is 7 billion, the total number of Homo sapiens ever to walk the Earth is nowhere near 1,000,000,000,000. I have chosen this example to demonstrate what a huge number 1 trillion, T12, is, and to show the remarkable recent growth of our global population. So what is a good, easily visualized example of 1,000,000,000,000 things, if not the number of people who have ever lived? To find out and to learn how to use powers of 10 to overcome innumeracy while solving remarkable problems, please watch the next video, RP2D. See the universe through a prism.